Hi there. With Snipcart, you can define simple and advanced discount scenarios to make your valuable customers happy. In this video, I'm going to show you how to configure discounts in your Snipcart dashboard. I'll then present to you three common use cases that should give you a good idea of how the feature works. Okay, let's start with a quick guided tour of the discount form in the dashboard. The first section of the form is where you configure general discount information. Here's what the different fields represent. The discount name will appear in the cart once applied by customers. Other than the name, the three other fields are all optional. You can set an expiration date if you want the discount to be valid until a specific moment. Next one is the maximum number of usage of the specific discount. Important to note that this is a global threshold and not a count per customer. Finally, you can set a currency filter. When applied, only cards created in the specified currency will be eligible for this discount. There is also a checkbox to indicate if this discount can be combined with other discounts. If you don't check the checkbox, it means that the current discount can only be applied if no other discounts is already applied in the customer's cart. The second section is the discounts action, where you decide what the discount will do. We offer multiple options here, some of them I'll explore in this video. The last section is where you choose how the discount will be applied. The most common option here is the manual discount, which I'll explain right away in my first use case. I'll begin with a straightforward example. Let's say I want to give $10 off to customers having a special promo code. I'll name this discount Special Offer and won't set any expiration date, max number of usage, or currency. In the Choose what the discount will do section, I'll use the option A prefixed amount will be deducted from the order. In the Amount field, I'll insert 10. In the Choose when the discount should be applied section, I'll keep it to Manually enter a discount code. The code will be the word Special. Now, if you go to your site, add an item to the cart and insert our code in the Promo Code field, it should do the trick. Let's go to use case number 2. With this one, I'll create a discount that will take 10% off any orders over a certain amount. I'll name it 10% on large orders. In the next section, I'll use the A percentage rebate on the total of the order option. In the rate text box, I'll insert 10. I want the discount to be applied on orders above $200. So I'll select when an order reaches a specific amount, and in total to reach, I'll insert 200. In this case, I'll leave the maximum amount to reach field empty. It can be useful when you want to offer a discount for cart amounts that are between two values. Let's test this in the cart. You'll see that if you increment the number of products to go over a total amount of $200, the discount is applied automatically. For my last use case, I'll create a discount to offer free shipping with specific items. So I'll create a new discount in the dashboard and call it Free Shipping on Starry Night, which is the name of the product I want to apply the discount on. What I want my discount to do is a discount on shipping. With this option, you can define a shipping method to offer. In my case, I'll offer a shipping method at $0, but it could be any price of your choice. I want to apply this discount when cart only contains specified products. This way, if other items are added to the cart, the discount won't be applied. In the Product IDs section, you can set one or multiple product IDs. A product ID is the value you set in the data item ID when defining your products in your HTML. In my case, the product ID I need is RZSN. Let's go test this in the cart one last time. If I add my specified product to the cart and only this product, I'll see the free shipping method available. It won't be the case if I add any other product to the cart. And that's it for me. As you might have noticed in the form, there are many more options on what discounts can do and when they should be applied. I invite you to explore them all to find the scenarios best suited for you and your customers. You'll find more information about every option in the discount section of our documentation.